the game. There's a throw down from umpire Green, and it's East Fremantle's Johnson that forces the ball up towards the half forward line. But in this quarter, Perth have made quite a big tactical change, and as much that Wanders has been brought down in front of the goals, and you will see him in the next few minutes kicking one or two of his team's four goals in this quarter. Perth a goal on the board, and they've started the long fight back. Here's a kick out by Monteith. McIntosh and Clark setting themselves for the mark, none taken, and it's Davis going through for Perth. Can't do anything with it. The East Fremantle backs force the ball out of bounds. From the throw-in, East Fremantle forcing the ball upfield, and this time it's Conway that comes through with it, drives it nicely upfield. Wandsbury intercepts there, can't do anything with it, out of bounds again. Following the throw-in, here's Regan, handballing over to teammate to Colson. Colson back to Regan, but the Perth team have intercepted, and in the scramble that ensues, umpire Green whistles up the game. From a throw-in, Sheedy of East Fremantle gets the ball away. He's been caught there. Interference to Sheedy, and he will take his kick. Umpire Green directing now. That's waiting while East Fremantle player has a shot at goals. There it goes, and here the goal umpire races for the right-hand flag. Two flags to East Fremantle and another full pointer on the board. Zuna this time takes the ball, drives the ball goalwards, but wide of the sticks. That's out of bounds. Now a point has brought them. East Fremantle backs defending desperately here as Perth start another onslaught. Zuna sockers the ball down in front of the goal now, but fumbling there has allowed the East Fremantle fullback Monteith to come through in dashing style, and he drives the ball along the grandstand wing. Jack Clark goes high, brings down the mark, knocks down to Ray French. French immediately forces the ball out onto the windward pocket. Following this throw-in, Percy Johnson and Clark in the air, and it's Johnson that's trying to get away. He's been tackled. And play on is the umpire's call, and Sheedy sockers upfield. Here's Bert Wandsbury shooting from goal from about 30 yards out, and there is a goal to Perth. The first of four goals that Bert Wandsbury kicked in the third term for the Redlegs. Down into the forward area again for Perth, but East Fremantle's Johnson is there. He's been tackled, forced to knock over to a teammate, and that teammate, Ken Ebbs, not found wanting, drives the ball upfield. Again, East Fremantle relieving, this time through Stewart. A kick out by Ashbolt. Down along the, towards the centre, with Armstrong going high, failing to bring down the mark. Harper overruns the ball. Zuna comes in to give him her hand and gets his kick in. Ball now comes along the southern wing. Up goes Ken Ebbs and a well-judged mark, but the play-on was evidently the decision. Zuna has a shot at goals, but it's a woeful effort, but Bert Wandsbury soon atones and brings up another full-pointer to Perth. From this throw-in, East Fremantle combining nicely, force the ball repeatedly into the windward pocket. Tom Davis has a shot at the goals, and there's a perfectly judged mark by Bert Wandsbury on his chest. Point-blank range, watch how he gets another one. Ray French on the mark, there goes the kick right down the centre, and another full-pointer to Perth. At a three-quarter time, East Fremantle, 8 goals, 6 behinds, 54 points. Perth, 7 goals, 10, 52. And with East Fremantle, with the breeze in the last quarter, it looked that East Fremantle would be home and hosed, but that was not to be. Here we find Guthrie forcing the ball down along the member stand wing and over to the half-forward line.